I'm Peter Frampton, and this is Mia Frampton, my daughter.
And this is what's in my bag.
It is. I wonder how you're feeling. There's ringing in my... Am I going first?
You can go first.
I found the definitive lead belly.
Tell me, where did you sleep last night? Come on, tell me.
This period is where it all sort of started happening. So, and where Robert Johnson and I'm not sure, he's Lead Belly's a little later than Robert Johnson, I believe. And it's just interesting listening to how each one changed it up and did it their way.
So I found Spoon, and this album is Transference. It's love forever. I just heard them on a movie soundtrack, and I just started to really like them. And I got a bunch of my friends into them, so that's why I got this one.
I'm a Robert Duvall fanatic. He's one of my all-time favorite actors. He said out of all the movies he's made, this one is his favorite.
I've decided to leave here forever.
Bees and dog.
Let me know if you're coming along.
Now I want to watch it again, bearing that in mind, because I loved it. Now I want to see why it's his favorite, you know, see if I can figure that out. So this is a all-time classic movie.
The next thing I got was the new Gorillaz album, and I really loved it. The first song I really loved was, what was that song? You know the song.
Oh, yeah. I don't, me and names.
No, you do. What is it?
I can't remember.
It's their most well-known song, and it was... It was featured on the Grammys, and everybody fell in love with it.
The one with the puppets.
Yeah, everybody knows. Anyway, so that's why I just got this one, because I've heard little snippets of it, and it's been amazing.
Okay, let's go fast forward. Let's do... sorry. I was a late bloomer with Radiohead. You know, sometimes it takes me a while. Once I did pick up on, start listening to Radiohead about 2 or 3 years ago, I now have everything they've ever done because I realized how good it is.
Yeah, yes. I definitely love Radiohead. My older brother turned him on to it, so.
This is definitely something that we do like together.
One thing that we do. What? One thing.
All right, just the one, just the one thing.
So this is The Flaming Lips.
Are you some kind of a hypnotist?
And I've never really bought anything of theirs, but I've heard such great things about it. I have heard the song Yoshima. I'm reading upside down. Yoshima battles the pink robot, and it was amazing. Like nothing I'd ever really heard, so I had to buy it. So.
I think, didn't they beat me out of a Grammy or something? Or did I beat them out of one? I won for the album.
Yeah, so I don't think, no sour grapes there.
No. They won for the track.
Oh.
And I was up for the track.
I think you're okay.
I did.
I think you did pretty good.
I did.
Yeah.
Taj Mahal was the first blues person that Humble Pie listened to altogether. So when we formed, Steve Marriott had this album with the track Leaving Trunk on it. And we all learned that track. And so to me, and it's the first track here, it's one of his most famous. He's such a emotional, you know, player and singer, and also so much you can learn from him.
So I got this one. I am a huge fan of Jimi Hendrix.
Above, that thing, that
play as well as my father play guitar, and I'm learning. And right now I'm working on solos, so I thought, who better to learn than from Jimi Hendrix?
No, he's the one you listen to.
Yeah. So, yeah, that's what I got. Okay. That's pretty funny.
Okay. Jimi Hendrix.
Yeah.
He was...
unlike anything.
Yeah, he wrote the guitar, bass electric guitar.
You
want to
do the Foo Fighters?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I was sitting in with the Letterman Band a few years ago, playing guitar, and they were the musical guest, and we played Show Me the Way, both bands going out of the show into commercial, and then when it came back we were still playing Show Me the Way. So I got to go and in Nashville they asked me, Dave asked me to go sit in with them, and I was actually standing at the time, so I stood in with them, and we did Show Me the Way for real live in front of the audience there, and it was very cool.
So my final one is probably my favorite. Kings of Leon has to be my favorite band of all time. I started listening to them probably 4 years ago, and I saw them live, and it was one of the best concerts I've ever been to, no offense. And it was just unreal, and I've been listening to them ever since. I do have a preference of their stuff, though. I do like their older stuff more than their new stuff, because it just sounds more raw, and their stuff now is still amazing. Some of it I listen to every day, but it's more converting to what people want them to do.
Tall and thin and young and lovely, the girl from Ipanema.
It's got Jobim playing guitar on it, and he's sort of pretty much defined the style of Brazilian guitar music, and is such a big part and wrote so many songs. I mean, Sinatra did an album with him, and so it's probably one of the most classic albums of this kind of music, so I'm just glad to have it again.
Thank you so much for talking with us today.
You're very welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And we've got some new music.
Yes. Man, that guy's guitar is talking.
Hey, my shoes are talking too. Amoeba.